Menachzor le'inyaneinu, and we'll return to what we were talking about. That through this, that the sage releases the vow in a way of flipping the darkness to light, which is the idea of this is the thing. Just like in the Korban Torah and the two breads of Shavuos, the chametz also is elevated. Because with wisdom you can elevate, you can purify. Now our sages said that releasing the vows is with one single expert, dafka, that is someone who is tested and stood through many tests. And the concept is ki amar razal b'sotos of perek velu ne'amarin dafmen beza modalaf amar abi yirmiya arba katos inan mekablin p'nei shechina, that there's four groups that do not receive the divine presence. Kas leitzim, v'kas chanefim, v'kas shekarim, v'kas misaprei lashon hara. Kas leitzim, you have the group of scoffers, of those who make fun and light of it. Dechsiv, hoshaya simin yuzayin, mashach yado eslo tzitzim, that he removes his hand from those who make fun. He pulls it away. Kas chanefim, the group of those who also make fun. Dechsiv, Iyov simin yud gimel, ki lo lefun of chanef yavo, that it says in Iyov, those who are chanefim will not come in front of him. Kas shikarim, those the group of liars. Dechsiv, tilim simin kufalav, dover shikarim lo ikon lenegedenai, those who speak false will not stand in front of my eyes. Kas misaprei lashon hara, and the group of those who speak lashon hara. Dechsiv tilim simin hei ki lo kel chafetz resha ata lo yegur chara, because you are not a kel who desires wickedness, and bad cannot live together with you. Ad kan lashon hara, that's the end of the quote. Ubreshis chach mashara hakadush erish parshi erish perak yud gimel. Hevi maimarazal hanal. He brings in Reshis Chachma that saying, because of the Zohar, lo dibru bichlal dalit kato selu, that in the Zohar, it doesn't mention at all these four groups. Vahanira derech klal, what seems in general, ki ilu pogmim ba'arba osios adnai, that these four groups blemish the four letters of Adnai, of Hashem Adnai. Lekach inan roim pnei hashchina, therefore they do not receive the divine countenance which corresponds with that name. Ratzeloma ki dalit katus ilu pogmin ba'adibur, that is because these four groups blemish the concept of speech. They're all of these, it's a concept of speech in each one of them. Hadibur hu malchus, and speech is the idea of malchus, shushem adnai, which is the name adnai. Vayim b'sidur shar rosh hashanah b'dibur amas, chil adnai savasay tiftach, nuk, what's brought in the idea of adnai, open the my lips. Umash shakos, b'lekuti torah parshas, Shlach b'dibur amas chil vata yigdal na kuach adnai, concerning the greatening, the strength of adnai, kasher dibarta limur, just like you spoke to say, also the dibur and adnai together with the greatening of that name. Vayim bepar de serach dibur davar dvarim yain sham. Look in pardes, where it talks about the three concepts of in the words of speech, dibur, davar, and dvarim. Ubitora or b'dibur amas chil v'idabar elokim chulu, so it's explained that the speech is called in the name of Elohim, Yir Elohim Uchulu, the city of our Elohim, Ein Sham, Ulikute Torah, Bibir Al Pasuk Shuva Yisrael. And in Likute Torah, an explanation of Return Israel, Va'ayin. Bigger Sakodesh, and look in Tanya, Simin Cafe, Bidibur Amas, Chilahavin Imre Bina, concerning the idea of to understand the words of wisdom, and to understand the words of understanding, bina. Mashikasu b'sefer anikra tzvas rivash. This that's brought in sefer the tzvav of Yisrael Baal Shem Tov b'dibur amaschil v'yas David Shem, o b'pagam, and in the blemish call ezukas shiyihya, whichever group it is, shiyare hu pogim b'chol Hashem, So he's blemishing the whole name. Kidelet Osius Hashem Kulam Shem Echad Heim, because all four letters together are one name. So if you blemish one, you've blemished the whole name.
And in the blemish of the Shekhinah, also the secret of
Hashem is the Shem Havaya is goes away from the Shekhinah. And if that's the case, then you're cutting off the unity. Therefore, you do not merit. It's like the idea of Kotzis Benetios. And therefore, you do not merit the idea of seeing the countenance of the Divine Presence. Visod Pnei Shekhinah, and the concept of the countenance of the Divine Countenance, Nivor Od Lekaman, will explain further on. Efshar Lomar Gimel Rishonos to Malchus, we could say you have these three first levels of Malchus. So
Pnei Shekhinah is the three first levels of Malchus. Yeah, that's the Pnei. The Pnimius, or the countenance of the Mochin. Which is like the face of the head. Ein Zor Chel Gimel Daf Ein Zayin Omud Beis Biyori Zor Hashem. Amayim Masha Kozvel Pasuk Luchal Mar Libi Bikshu Fanai. And look what's brought about to you. My heart says to search for your countenance. Search my countenance. Ein Masha Kozvel Lekaman. Binyan Masai Avo Ve'era Pnei Elokim. Concerning the idea of when will I come and see the countenance of Elohim, but Moshe Rabbeinu, Olav Hashalom, Ksiv Upanai Lo Yirao, and Moshe Rabbeinu it says, you will not see my countenance. You can only see my backside and the cleft of the rock. Yishlomar, we can say, Al Derech Bechayehen Einan Roin, we can say that it's not something you can see in your lifetime. While you're alive, you could say that the grasping of Moshe in the supernal wisdom there, that's where he says that you cannot see my countenance. But we can say that in terms of the Shekhinah itself, they receive the countenance of the Shekhinah. So the Bikshu Fanai and Panai Lo Yirao is a higher level than Pnei Shekhinah. So in the Pnei Shekhinah, they did merit. And when we say Bikshu Fanai, it's not referring to the countenance of the divine countenance, it's referring to a higher level. Vayim b'medrash tilim al pasuk yashvu yisharim ispanecha, like what's brought to Sprod, medrash tilim about those who sit in front of your countenance, v'zeo kitapuach v'atzei ayar, and that's the idea of like an apple in the trees of the wild forest, atzei ayar hin sairos, that the trees of the forest are like hairs that grow, the forest of hairs. Kamushikasu avos to Rabbi Nasan, sof parsha lamad bara elokim, chorshin yar ba'olam, bara chorshin ba'adam. The Holy One, blessed be He, created forests in the world, and He created forests in a person. In a person, hainu hasaidos, and that's the hairs. V'niksiv v'shir hashirim shir zayin, that's brought in shir hashirim, v'dalas rashich, Argaman, that the hairs that hang down are like purple wool. Upedish Bitikune Zohar, Shim Taimea Torah, or maybe like red wool. And it's brought in Tikune Zohar that these are the musical notes of the Torah, and bechinas dalas rasheich sairus tenukva, and these are the concept of those hairs that hang down of the feminine aspect. So it maybe that's like the top of the concept of the divine of the countenance of the Shekhinah. B'makom acher pirush kein sairus dezeran pin, and another place it explains that there the hairs of Zohar, kfutzosav taltalim hulo, that they're the groups of hairs that hang down. Shchoros ka'orev, so maybe it's two ideas, but or maybe it's one idea. V'lo sisriya dadi hulo, but it doesn't contradict al kol panim. Mebechinas mochin v'chabad shebemalchus. At any rate, you have the intellect and the mochin of malchus, Chochma bin Adas of Malchus. Shin Gimel Rishona Sheba Malchus and Yochol Avo Biskalus Bia. That cannot be revealed into the lower worlds or beats. Yonasirak Derech Sairos, only through hairs. Shemut Rimochin, which are the leftovers of the brains. That's the poor part, the poverty of your head, the lower levels of the mochin. They're the ones that come down. Shem bechinas gimel gavnin chulu, that the argaman is composed of Rafael, Gabriel, Michal, Nuriel, which are just in general the three gavnin, three colors, three midos. Gimel gavnin chulu vayminin vidal srashich gargaman, and look at this pasuk. It explains that it's the idea of the hand tefillin, it's the Rosh HaNukva. It talks about how many souls and how many angel, hairs. The Talian Mina that are dependent upon Malchus can invin biskalachulu like grapes from a vine. Those are just so too are the neshamas from Malchus. Perish v'dalas rasheich shemanimin. So what does it mean? Dalas rasheich. They're the hairs of him ka'argaman that corresponds with argaman shem amirkava kedosha. That's the holy mirkava. Refal mechal gavriel chulu k'moshikazov shem b'tikuni zor b'tikuni urches tikun vav davkuf mem beiz amud beiz. Vain sham daf kuf mem gimel amad alef tikun ayin daf kuf lamed gimel sof amad alef because they were inyan vidalas rasher shem asayrus motrim ochin. All of this is the concept of the what comes from the head, the hairs, the leftovers of the brain, him kargaman. They are like argaman, like the malachim, like the midos. They come down. Ach ketapuach zehu haros pnei shechina. So, but the apple, which is like the radiance of the countenance of the Shechina, Yair Hashem Panav Yilecha, Hashem will shine His countenance towards you, the Targum, Yinahir Hashem Shechintei Levasach, that the translation is that the Hashem will shine His Shechina to you, that's Panav is the Shechina, Vapanim Panoy Misairos, and the fat countenance is devoid of hairs. And so it's a higher level, V'chachmas Adim Toyo Panav, and Hashem, a person's wisdom, will shine their countenance. That is the essence of wisdom, not just leftover brains. That's why it says, like the apples of the trees of the forest. So you have just like the trees of the forest, to the hairs, but the apple of the trees is the idea that's panoim misairos from the forest. That's the tapuchin. And that's the idea of the countenance of the Shechina, the face of the Shechina, to receive, to be satiated with the joy of the countenance of Asmachos, v'chasher tedaktik, so it's a higher level. V'chasher tedaktik, when you scrutinize tims or kolkas pagambos echad, each group blemishes one letter, kas litziim bios aleph, a group of scoffers blemishes one letter, bos yud v'chulu, and in the letter Yud, a different group and so forth, each one blemishes a letter. And from these four katos, from the fact that Hashem did not conduct us through the land of the Plishtim, that they litzanim hayu, that they were leitzim. So go to the land of Israel, Malchus. You cannot go through the land of the Plishtim. You cannot blemish the Shema Adonai, the Bnei Shechina. Efshal Lomar, the Isa, B'medr Shraba, Parsha, Kedoshim, Parsha, Chav, Dalet, Al Pasuk, Yavai, Lokecha, Misalech, Bekerev, Machanecha. Now it's brought in Medrash on the verse that Hashem, your Lokecha, travels in the midst of your camp, Latzilcha, to save you. Ma'u Latzilcha, Yoscela Loshecha. What does it mean, Latzilcha? To become a shadow upon your head, Valetzu Prikasol. And the scoffer is the removal of the yoke of heaven, Gorim Shmistalek Tzel, that causes this shadow to be removed from you, me'al rosho, from upon someone's head, shari nemo, lo yira b'cha irvas davar v'shav me'acharecha, because it says you will not find in you a naked thing, and go back away from you, and remove himself from you, pirish irvas davar, irvas dibur. And what does it mean? The nakedness of the davar, you can say, it's improper speech. Irvas dibur lekach leitzhefech tzeil chulun. Therefore, the scoffer is the opposite of the shadow of tzeil, the same letters, leitz and tzeil. And the leitz is the blemishing of the dibur, and therefore it causes the tzeil, the shadow of Hashem, to go away because of irvas davar. B'mishle simin tesyud beiz, and in mishle im chachamta chachamta lach v'latz tel levadecha sisa. If you were wise, you were wise for yourself. I guess you draw down chokhmah to you. V'latzta, and if you're late, levadecha tisa, you'll carry it alone. Meaning that you have the histalkus from you of the presence of the supernal chokhmah or the shechina and so forth. V'aymiza beperek lifnei day and daf yud chesam alf beiz yalkut chilek beiz peites beiz b'chaye. Tzadik Vav Aleph, Parshas Yisro, V'chmiru Razal Binyan Zeh, and our sages were strict in this matter, Shamu Perek Beis Davos, that our sages said, in the second chapter of Avos, Shnaim Shiyoshvim, Ve'ein Beinehem Divrei Torah, that you have two people who do not have amongst them words of Torah, Harezim Ushav Litzim, it's a group of scoffers, so even to not have Torah, Shinemar B'mushav Litzim Lo Yashav, like it says, and they did not sit in a group of scoffers. Vayin shamatam b'reishis chachma, and look over there. B'reishis chachma v'nitzel u'b'chinas sukkah b'tziluchim marativ yashav tichulu. Now the concept of the shadow is like a sukkah. In his shadow, I was pleasant and I sat. Kas chanefim. So that's all leitzim. Kas chanefim, the group of the chanefim k'neged Hashem. K'neged hey corresponds, is against the letter hey of Hashem's name. Because what is a chanef? It's someone who speaks one thing in their mouth and has another in their heart. That's a chanef. So it's found that he's blemishing both the mind and the heart. The concept of the chanef in Shurashim, stammer from the Radak, he brings that it's a wicked person and also someone who everybody likes or is nice to. But it's from Yishaya, Rasha, and Supanim. Yishaya, Simin Chavtal Hashem, V'Hartz, Chanfa Tachas Yoshvea, it says that the earth was tricking those underneath its those that dwelled upon it. Meaning that it had one thing inside, but it gave out another thing. Rashi can mean chanifus osa esavenu osa kama, that it's like a one thing in the heart and one thing in the mind, in the mouth, that it gives forth grass, but it's not giving forth grain. Mare kama ve'en chitin b'kosheya, that it gives forth standing grain, but you do not have any wheat inside of these stalks. And needs to be understood this verse in Masay that do not tachnif the aretz, ki adam hu yachnif the aretz, because the blood will machnif the aretz and so forth. What's the intention that it'll over here? And according to this definition, ma inyan shin pedal lechanufa. What's the concept of spilling blood to this idea of tricking, doing one thing in the heart and one thing in the mouth? Barav Eben Ezra perush yachani fusera b'seser. In the Eben Ezra, he says this word means to do bad in a hidden way. So I guess that would be to spill blood. Would be that the earth covers over the murder of someone, and from this is drawn the idea that the earth tricks underneath it those who dwell upon it. You don't know all the sins that were done there, or that the earth is hiding. Histalkus Hashchina, and you have the which is the concept. So v'ha'aretz chanfa, so the earth itself is the Shechina. Chanfa tachas yoshvea, it's hidden, becomes hidden. It's like the hidden thing that the, but it's not a hidden bad. But if chanef means to hide something, so chanfa aretz tachas yoshvea means that the earth malchus, or the Shechina, is hidden from underneath those that dwell upon it. Because that's what the arts is. It's something that people dwell upon. So Malchus, that is the arts, it becomes hidden. Perek Beis, the Shabbos Taf Lamed Gimel Amud Aleph. So it's the concept of Histalkus Hashchina. B'Zohar Sanhedrin, Parsha Zayin Beis, Daf Kaf Dalet Aleph, Hinei Shtayim Nashim Chulot. So you have two women, Zuchanufa V'Gasas Ruach Sh'yadu L'Bavil Chulot. That refers to these two bad midos, chanufa and haughtiness of spirit, that went down into exile from in the nevuah of Zechariah. Shtaim nashim b'medrash rabas of parsha vayir reish parsha mimches al pasuk pach to b'tzion chataim, on the verse that those who are in Tzion who sin should fear achzarada chanefim, and that those who are chanef grasp them. The trembling of out of fear. So that these people who have this avera should be fear. Amar Rabbi Yonos and Chanufa Shenemar Mikra Beminus Akos Medaber. So Rabbi Yonos says in Medrash Rabba Vayera that Chanufa that's mentioned here. It's speaking about people who, like apikorsim, I mean, someone who denies the Torah, binyan av shebekulam. And how do we know this from the pasuk that builds this idea for all of them? Pachtu b'tzion chataim achzarada chanefim. That fear and see on those sinners and tremble, and grasp the trembling to the chanefim. So the chanefim is something higher or worse than the sinners and so forth. Arkan shono. Ubitargam Yonason Sham Pirush chanefim Mishiyaya Tahava Meganvin Urchehon. So the Targum Yonason Ben Uziel, he says the chanefim refer to the wicked that steal their ways, steal their paths. Vayin b'pasuk zeh b'yalkut chilek beis daf tzadik dalet beis remez tafresh samach gimel b'tchilaso parshatest brachos daf samach. So that's three different definitions in chanefim. One in the heart, one in the mouth, and the second is the Ibn Ezra that it's the blood spilled in the earth. What gets hidden in the earth. And the third here is that it refers to minus. Perek tes the brachos daf samach ezor chilek gimel vayikra daf yurches amud alef daf kuf alef amud alef b'chayi parshas sav daf kuf lamed vav amud alef gabi haol al mokta vav al pichein isa bepirkei derabbi eliezer parsha lamed zayin mekana amunu shemachanifin isa reshayim b'olam hazeh. And nonetheless, even with all this, it says that from here we can we learn that you can fool the wicked in this world. So there's a positive concept of machanifim, that we can do it to the Rishayim. I guess that we can trick the wicked. And the group of liars, they blemish the third letter, the letter of Vav, of Hashem's name, Shalshim. Because sheker is connected MS, and the vav is says by Rachav that you should give me a letter of truth, which is vav. And that is because tiferes is the middle line in Zah, in the partsuvim. Look what's brought about the concept of give truth to Yaakov, that Yaakov can be spelled with a vav as well. And because he took it from Eliyahu to be mevaseh the gula, lashon hara neged hey achrona, and the lashon hara corresponds with the last letter of Hashem's name. I am l'kutei Torah pashas mitzora v'nei gilui ze adavar. So the bia from of Yaakov with the vav and Eliyahu is in from Maim from Tavshin Chavtes, and mevachim echodesh elul. So the fourth level, lashon hara neged yachrona, and b'lukotei Torah pasha mitzora, v'negilei ze adavar, yichudi la ze b'chinas v'emes Hashem l'olam. Now the concept of to reveal this thing, so obviously the lashon hara corresponds with the hey yachrona, is malchus is the dibur and shibi dibur. The lashon hara itself, now to reveal this is the thing, zeh davar is the supernal unity, is the idea of and the truth of Hashem is to the world. If so, the four groups that blemish the Shem Hashem, it's the opposite of this. Therefore, he has to be clear and clean and expert and in not having those four levels. Kitzer yachid mumcha, we talked about the single expert, dalet katos leitzim chanefim shkarim lashonara, we talked about the four groups of scoffers and chanefim and liars and those who speak badly. Pogmim medalet osios adnai medalet osios avaya, that they blemish the four letters of Shem Adnai and the four letters of Shem Avaya. And we talked about Aleitz Hepech Tzel. Aleitz is the opposite of the shadow of Hashem. So there's the you're not Zoche Pnei Shechina, which is the concept of the shadow. Vishav Me'acharach Atzar Tzilam. And also it corresponds with this idea of Atzar Tzilam Me'alehem, which is the idea of the Makiv that surrounds them, goes away. So we see that the Tzel corresponds with Aleitz. Chanefim Rasha Arum. And we talked about how chanefim, one of the definitions is from the Ibn Ezra, a clever. And we talked about the chanefim, one of the definitions is rasha, the clever, wicked person who hides what he's doing.